So then a corporation on the defensive over the alleged questionable sale of shares in the Malampaya project. But then a corporation president, Raymundo Escalona, says the issues thrown against them are politically motivated and baseless. Udena acquired a 90% stake in the Malampaya project by buying the 45% stake of Chevron for $565 million and another 45% stake from Shell for $460 million. Escalona says both Chevron and Shell are international oil and gas firms that cannot be swayed by a mere call by Udena CEO Dennis Uy.
If you don't have all of the facts of the matter at hand, I urge you, I really urge you, to try to really find out all of the facts and at least give us the courtesy of the benefit of the doubt. It's really unfair. And it's already affecting my and the group's ability to be able to financially close pending transactions. It's affecting the livelihood of thousands of our employees.
Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi and Uy are facing graft charges over the controversial deal.
The Philippine Central Bank keeps a patient hand, holding interest rates at record lows due to easing inflation. Juan de Guzman reports.
For an eighth straight rate-setting meeting, the Philippine Monetary Board kept key interest rates unchanged and at record lows as part of a vow to remain supportive of the Philippine economic recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic.
The sum of new data suggests that there remains scope to hold monetary policy settings steady amid a manageable inflation environment. The Monetary Board maintains that keeping a patient hand on the BSP's policy levers, along with the appropriate fiscal and health interventions, will keep the economic recovery more sustainable over the next few quarters.
The Philippine Central Bank also adjusted its inflation outlook for 2021 downward.
Previous policy meeting held last September, we were looking at a baseline inflation of 4.4%. With a favorable outturn of inflation in September and October recently, we're now revising that downward to 4.3%.
Everyone expected the central bank to keep rates unchanged Thursday, including BPI lead economist June Neri. Neri says it is possible the central bank won't be able to adjust interest rates for a couple of quarters because of the 2022 elections. He says this delay could be painful, especially if the United States hikes its own interest rates earlier than expected.
Our GIR is still strong, still big. Governor mentioned earlier, it's still bigger than external debt. But is it worth draining or depleting our reserves as rapidly in case something like that happens to the U.S. Versus hiking by 25 basis points? The last three elections show that there were no adjustments in the policy settings the first 5 months of a presidential election year. So if there's no hike on Thursday, there's no hike on December, that's why we're thinking, June is probably the earliest rate. And unfortunately, we would have lost a lot of GIR already in the process.
Philippine Central Bank Deputy Governor Francisco Dakila, however, says politics play no role in monetary policy decisions.
Political developments are not a significant consideration in formulating monetary policy. We've always been emphasizing that the decision of the board on monetary policy is guided by the inflation outlook.
Higher interest rates are generally unpopular because these make loans less affordable. And the Duterte administration, as well as the central bank, have been trying to use low-interest loans to jumpstart economic activity.
We are coordinating also with fiscal authorities in this normalization phase, so as not to unduly affect the national government's pandemic response program.
The last policy meeting for 2021 is in December, and typically there will be at least two policy meetings before May, when the elections will be held in 2022. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
Prominent candidates in the Philippine presidential race share their proposed government programs as they face business community leaders in a forum. More details in this report.
Our friends from the media.
Presidential aspirants try to woo businessmen during a virtual forum organized by the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Domagoso was among those who presented his plans should he win the presidency. He says he will slash taxes on oil and electricity. Moreno also eyes creating more housing projects for the poor and push for the establishment of a fisheries department.
Rest assured, I will be fearless confronting problems. We will be fair in addressing it and doing action plan, programs of governance. And I will be loyal and faithful to every Filipinos.
Senator Manny Pacquiao is looking to spend big on infrastructure projects. These include bullet trains, subway systems, and skyways. But Pacquiao wants to steer clear from borrowing money from foreign countries.
Igit sa lahat yung infrastructure development. Kasama po yan sa paglago ng ating ekonomiya. Mag-focus po tayo. Yung revenue income ng ating bansa, kailangan doon tayo nakafocus dahil hindi po tayo deserving na mangungutang. No? Hindi deserving ng mga Pilipino na mangutang taon-taon.
Vice President Leni Robredo vows to address poverty and hunger during her first days in office if she wins the presidential race next year.
In our first 100 days, we'll focus on addressing our most urgent problem, controlling the pandemic and mitigating its impact on our people's lives. This means increasing support for our healthcare workers, improving hospital capacity, and making COVID testing more accessible to more Filipinos. We'll set aside 216 billion pesos in the national budget for ayuda distribution to protect families from hunger and provide them with their basic needs without being forced to go to work.
Senator Panfilo Lacson, for his part, will prioritize digitalization to ramp up the country's economic recovery. Lacson says the first step to this is the full implementation of the National Broadband Program.
This will be critical to connect, unify, and automate all our government processes for efficient business transactions, increased revenue collections, and eradication of corruption in all levels of our bureaucracy. I am sure that our digital reforms will not only bridge our digital divide, but will also boost our competitive edge as a country of great potential in the digital world.
And for administration bet Senator Bongo, he wants to sustain the gains from programs that began under President Duterte.
I regard President Rodrigo Duterte as the best president this country has ever had. Iniwasan ko po ang posisyon na ito, but fate has a way of turning things around. Presidency, I believe, is a matter of destiny.
Former Senator Bongbong Marcos Jr. skipped the virtual event.
A House lawmaker urges the Philippine Competition Commission to look into the high prices of pork in Metro Manila. Marikina Representative Stella Kimbo believes this could only be explained by a possible collusion or manipulation within the supply chain. Kimbo points out it has been 6 months since the effectivity of executive orders lowering tariffs on imported pork and increasing the volume of pork that can be imported at a lower tariff. And yet, she says, prices have still not gone down significantly. The PCC says it will look into the possible anti-competitive practices at play. But so far, it says it has not seen irregularities in the supply chain.